Hello children, welcome to the fourth day. So today I am going to teach you the cultural heritage of Gujarat, and today is the last topic of this first chapter, Heritage of India. And today we are going to learn cultural heritage of Gujarat, fairs of Gujarat, preservation and conservation of our heritage. So let us start with the topic. You know very well that yesterday we have learnt about the natural heritage and cultural heritage of India, and how the Aryans and Dravidians are Aryans and Dravidians cultures. So let us start the fourth class. So these are all about cultural heritage of Gujarat. You can see the pictures. This pictures is of Lothal and Dholabira. Which Lothal you can know, it is a big port. So let us learn about all the points. The archaeological places like Lothal, which is in Dholka Taluka, Dholabira, which is in our Kutch district, Rojadi is in Rajkot, Rangpur in Limbadi district, it is in Surendranagar, and some of the places you can see the pictures of this Victory Tower, Madeira Temple, pilgrimage places like Sun Temple of Madeira, Victory Tower of Vadnagar, stone inscription of King Ashoka at Junagadh, Gate of Champaran. You can see the pictures like Rudra Mahalaya, some of the tourist places like Rudra Mahalaya in Sidhpur, Jama Masjid, Mansar Lake, Viramgam, Sastraling Lake, like Patan, Jhulta Minar. These are the festivals and fairs and festivals. You know very well Navratri, Kite Festival. Some tourist places and festival like Polo Forest, Kankariya Lake, Kite Festival, Navratri, Tanturiya Festival. So all these things which we have already known about our culture, our cultural festivals, our fair. Because we used to be of these places of Gujarat. So for this, we are always proud that we are staying in Gujarat, and we should be proud for our Gujarat cultural heritage. And it also has a great place in our Indian cultural heritage. Some of the religious places also include in this cultural heritage of Gujarat, like Dwarkadish Temple, Somnath Temple, Ambaji, Samalji. You can see the Tantera Fair in Gujarat, Samalji Fair in Gujarat. These fairs of Gujarat in your textbook, in page number 4, it is clearly mentioned when this fair is going, what is the time of this fair, and what is in which place this fair generally held. So these fairs of Gujarat, so all the times it is coming in Varma questions, maybe for match the following, might be in true or false, or might be in Varma questions. So this fairs of Gujarat is very important. And after the school reopen, I will also take a taste of this fairs of Gujarat. So I will give a project on this. You have to do at least 5 fairs of Gujarat, the places as well as for the time and the time for this fair. So you have to underline and note down all the points of this whatever I have shown you today. Now let us coming up to the last topic, that is preservation and conservation of our heritage. You know very well, children, ki heritage means the things which were blessed from our forefathers or from our ancestors or also from God, because heritage are of two types. You understood that is natural and cultural. So both the heritage gives pride to our country. So it is our foremost and very it is our foremost duty and responsibility to preserve and conservation of our heritage. So because heritage, you know, heritage brought glory to our nation. As per the Article 51, yeah, in that 6, 7 and 9, it describes for the preservation of our cultural heritage. Why? It is for to understand the importance of our culture. And it is also maintains how to maintain our environment, like how to maintain our forest, river, birds, along with the natural environment, how to comprise all the living characteristics. And the very important things, how to protect our public property. Because whenever we are traveled by bus, by train, by flights, we are also public toilets are also there, public roads are also there. So we should have to protect all the public property. So it is our foremost duty to maintain our surroundings. How to maintain the surroundings? We have already done in from school, like last year, Swachhata Abhiyan, we all had a nukkad on that also. So what you have done all this? We have done all this because it is our duty to protect our public property. So all these public properties should be protected. And so why we have done this? Because nature, this nature has created a beautiful landscapes in where we are living. We are getting all these things to eat, food, whatever food we eat, this is also given by our nature. So our surroundings, these are also gifted from the nature. So we should maintain purity, sanctity and beauty. And Indian heritage is a result of the development of the people of India in the social, economical, political and cultural field. That means, so if we are maintaining it properly, if we are preserving it properly, if we are conserve our heritage in a proper way, then what will happen? There will be a development, all round development of India, that is in social field it also develop, economical also develop, political as well as in the cultural field. So our foremost duty, our responsibility, that to conserve or preserve our cultural and natural heritage, which gives pride to our country and which gives pride to our nation and makes our nation the best one in the world. So that is our, we should have to take a place on that. That is our foremost duty. It is our duty. It is our responsibility to preserve and conserve our natural, our heritage. So these are all for the today's topic. So today I am concluding this chapter with this. So in the next slide, I am giving you all the book review, what we have done, what we have learnt. So that is, let's have a quick brief on all the topics, whatever we learnt in this chapter. So first we learnt what is heritage. So heritage means, what is heritage? Did you understand what is heritage? Heritage are the valuable gifts from our ancestors or our forefathers. So this heritage is of two types, natural and cultural. Natural heritage are the heritage which are God-made. Cultural heritage are the heritage which are man-made. Then we came to know what is culture. Culture kya hai? So culture is the sum total of our habits, our values, customs, traditions and conducts of the lifestyles of human. It is the journey from the cave to the home, that means from the darkness to the light. And what is natural heritage? Natural heritage, I have already discussed, that will be a long questions might be. Natural heritage, briefly, that will be right. Natural heritage, all the points first. Then you have to write about landscapes, rivers, vegetation and wildlife. Then cultural heritage. Cultural heritage of India, that means all the places, all the religious places, all the tourist places, all the monuments, or like from starting from the Indus Valley civilization till today, whatever the monuments will be there, you have to write all sorts in details. I have given you the notes in my next slide. So please be with me. The next slide is very important. All these book review points have given it very clearly so that you could be understand. Then how natural and cultural heritage are interdependent. As we already discussed, natural and cultural are interdependent because whatever natural has been given, it has been maintained by us. So if there will be no dependent of natural and cultural, how it will be dependent? So this question also I have given it details in my next slide. Now cultural heritage of Gujarat, today also we discuss about this. Now details about Dravidians and Aryans, this is also very long questions, important questions might be coming in your board. Short notes of Negroid, then Astroloid, then preservation of our heritage. So all these question answers I have given in my next slide, day 5. So please go through all the notes, and if possible, not possible, you have to write in your notebook, because after the reopen of the school, we are going to take your exam. So for that, these are all for today. So thank you very much.